Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to create this nice sundown effect. So like the sun going down at the seaside and we see those ripples on the water. Okay, let's start with this and I'm going to draw a circle and it already has this gradient applied. Let's just pick it up from here, like so. And now we need half of that. So I'm going to select this lower point with the direct selection tool and just delete it. So now we have the sun in half and let's go to the gradient panel and just rotate that gradient so that it gets more realistic. The next thing is we need the lower half. So I'm going to make a copy of this, rotate it around and then just snap it to the sun. And the smart guides tell me where to go. The next thing to get this, I'm going to Effect, Stylize, Scribble. And you see, this is already pretty nice, but the default of this is a little different. So let's take a look at how to get this. So what you need to do is set the angle to 0. You see, this is the angle, set it to 0 or maybe around 0, that's okay as well. And then you need to adjust, you see, this is the stroke width of this, like so. You can adjust the curviness of the edges, which is this one. And then, of course, get some variation in it. So the lower slider is always the variation. And this is the spacing of those ripples. And then, of course, the path overlap is, you know, how much they overlap the actual shape. So, like so, and then we go to OK. Now, what's not so nice about this is there are those sharp corners in there, and I want to get rid of that. But for this, we need to expand everything. So, let's first go to, and I'm going to make a copy because I need that once more. So, let's take this, and in order to expand the effect, go to Object Expand Appearance. Okay, and now I'm going into Outline View and you see it got expanded. That's nice, but I like some more variation in this. You see in my first drawing, this path gets thinner, but I can't do that with this shape. So in order to get that, let's go to this here again. In order to get that, I could have used a width profile. But to this, I can't apply a width profile. So I need a different expanding and I need to expand it as a stroke. But this does not work with the gradient. So when you have a gradient applied, then Illustrator expand it as a shape. So we're going to change that. We're going to set it to a solid color and then Object Expand Appearance. And then you see we actually get the scribble effect expanded as an open path with a fat stroke. That is nice. That's what I wanted. And now we can apply a width profile to that. But let's first take a look at what came into existence. So let's go to the Layers panel. And in here we see this is grouped. It's just a path inside a group. So let's get rid of that because it would cause us some pain if we left it. So let's just release that group like so. And then we can get into width profiles. They are up here like so. And you see, yeah, this gets nice, but it's too thin at the end. So let's take the width tool and let's see if we can drag that. But that doesn't work for some reason. And this is because there might be some angles inside of this. So let's just double click it. The width point needs to be inside there. Make it a little wider and you see we get them and there they are. So now we see where to drag them and then I can make them thinner. Let's take a look at it. And you see in here, that is not nice. It's a corner and Illustrator always puts with points at the corners. So in order to get a proper path, we need to create one. So let's start with a line and put uniform to it. And then you can use the width tool on that line. Let's just make it a little thinner, but not zero at the end, like so. And you see, this is nice. We can make it thicker here. And then select this one. Take the eyedropper. I'm going to double click it. It needs to look like this in order to pick up everything. So let's just pick it up. That's nice. Okay. Now you can refine that, of course. You can take the width tool and go in here and make it thicker here if you want, like adjust it any way you like. But let's leave it like this. So, and again, let's make another duplicate because why not? And now we need to still get rid of those points. And in order to do that, we need to make this to a shape. So, object, path, outline stroke. There we are. And there are all those overlaps. Get rid of those as well. So go to Window, Pathfinder, and unite all of this. That's nice. And then we can finally go to the Direct Selection tool, select those corners, and you see, adjust them like so. And in order to finalize this, of course, we need to pick up the gradient again. But yeah, you know how to refine this and you can now use anything you like on that shape. And then you get the nice flowing sundown ripple effect in your artwork. And you have learned something about some Illustrator functions as well.